This is my first impression of Eldritch, which, from what I know, is a roguelike that's 3D with some Minecraft stuff in it. Let's see what it's like. Know only a little bit about it. Let's see what's in the options. Probably WASDA. I think it's supposed to have influence on from H.P. Lovecraft as well. Okay. Space FQE. Okay. It's all right. Crouch is C. Okay. Z and X. I think I got it. We can always go back. Let's give it a shot. Okay. So I'm apparently in a study of some kind. Pretty basic level layout here. Let's see if I can interact. I can. Kind of cool. So I was a big fan of the Alone in the Dark series of games when I was a young man. Kind of look in the mirror. That's me. Oh, I guess I get to design my character here. And I think this has some influence from there as well. So let's see if we can find an Edward Carnsby kind of looking character. A sir, as it were. I guess that's close. Let's see if we can find a sirish outfit. That's sirish. Not so much. Not so much. Doesn't have no boobs. Let's go with that. All right. But that series was quite good. I might actually do a playthrough series on that. I quite liked those games. I was fond of them, and I'm still fond of them. So turning on the lights, let's see if we turn on all these lights, if anything happens. Probably not. I know I'm stretching here, but why not, right? Like, it's what it's all about, playing and having fun. So running, hopefully the frame rate isn't tearing or anything, or the frames aren't tearing. Eldritch Library, Borrower Ledger. Item number 9713 J.K. Pippin. So it's 1927, I guess. This is the latest checkout. So February 15th, 1927, apparently. Can't page through, only can do that, okay. So now we know what timing it is. She explains some of the styling of this stuff. The shadows are interesting in this game. Let's turn off all the lights and see if anything happens. It's got a very toony, toony kind of renderer to it, I guess. I feel like it's a quite a vast space, and I'm not sure about the scale yet. So what's this? A book. Shall I read it? Oh, that looks fancy over there. There's lots of books. So this is a library. Wonder if we put things on the pedestals here. Pedestal has a shallow indentation engraved with a strange pattern. Looks like a spherical object could be placed here. Yep, so apparently we maybe collect things and unlock some master door here. Can't get through it now. Okay, let's read the book. Explorer's Journal, page 2. This library seems to go on forever. I am no longer certain that there is a way out. It feels as if I am somehow reliving the same experiences, day after day, endlessly. If I am to find an exit from this madness, I believe it will be through those obscene glowing books. There is unimaginable power in those pages and unspeakable horror. It seems that the spirits of ancient deities lie dormant within the books, though I know not for what reason, but their collected power must be in the key to my incarceration in this labyrinth. So apparently I'm stuck in this library, and that's interesting. So glowing books. These must be them over here. What are these? Press space to jump. Okay, so it's like a tutorial. What did it say? Press and hold. Pull yourself up. Cool. Like a Tomb Raider kind of element, or a Prince of Persia, depending on your age. while sprinting, crouch to execute a power slide. What? Nice. Not sure why you would want to do that. While crouching, you can fit into small passages. Your footsteps will make less noise. Okay. Let's see. I guess they're saying hop up, Buttercup. These extraterrestrial stone carvings are your main resource in this world. You can purchase goods with them or spend them to activate special powers. Okay, so there's something nice that I can grab. Maybe buy some things. Not sure if there's any secret doors or anything. Already read that one. The default controls are not comfortable. Yeah. Q to lean left and right. Your visibility to enemies is not affected by leaning, so you can use it to safely peek around corners while staying hidden. Okay. Some Splinter Cell-like stuff. I guess this is kind of trying to be a stealthy game as well. There must be logic in the code to for monsters to detect us. This looks interesting over here. Bunch of things. It's over here. A bottle. Press right trigger or mouse left to throw a punch. Roll a projectile or fire a weapon. Press Z or Y to drop the object in your right hand. Okay, you can carry two weapons or objects at the same time. Got it. So X is swap. Z drops it. Cute. Can I have a ham? I don't want to eat it yet. Okay, I can't. Can't pick it up because I already got something. So let's try and whip it against the wall and see if it breaks. It does. Okay. I'm gonna keep a few of these in my inventory, presuming I have one. No. Eating food will restore some of your health. Be careful, eating spoiled or poisonous food may harm you instead. 10-4. So that was good. Apparently I have health and coins and keys, and not sure what that yellow thing is. Maybe a doorway or I am not sure. It's strange to have ham just sitting out on a library table. Nothing back here, apparently. What's this? Checkers, anyone? Okay, I don't want to necessarily eat it because I've already gotten it. And I already have a bottle, so let's keep going here. See what else there is. So obviously, I could eat the fruit. Not going to. I think maybe these things are permagon, so I don't want to do that yet. History of the Library, Volume 3 of 4. In the early 20th century, when the old ones threatened the Earth. Yep, so it's definitely H.P. Lovecraft, Cthulhu-like stuff. For the second time, the Guardians reconvened in New England to perform the ritual of binding once again. A modest library was chosen to host the rite, and the Guardians elected one among them, the Librarian, to remain at the prison and protect it from further disturbances. Okay, that's great. Where's volume 1? Over here? This place is pretty big. Is there a map? Apparently not. It's kind of creepy, actually, just all of this volumetric lighting and books. Here's volume 2. Okay, let's see if we can find volume 1. Volume 4. Is this volume 1? Volume 3. Where is volume 1? And what's up there? Is the question. Let's see if we can get up. Maybe the volume 1 is up here. Up you go. Up you go, little guy. I have seen some YouTube videos, so my knowledge level is somewhat educated, I guess you could say, of... I don't remember who played it. It might have been Paul Soares Jr. Okay, here's volume 1. And I just took a look and was it piqued my interest enough to buy it in a Steam sale. The History of the Library, Volume 1 of 4. Legends tell of a catastrophic event thousands of years ago, when Earth fell to the wrath of the Old Ones. The few survivors discovered an ancient rite, which they used to seal the dreadful beings in a labyrinthine prison. Life on Earth once again flourished, and the survivors formed a convent, of guardians to protect the secret ritual of binding. Scary. What's this book? It's your library, volume 3. Wait, hold on a minute. Hold the phone. Hold the phone. I climbed up. Unless maybe this is like one of those M.C. Escher-like designs. Volume 3, I read that. I know I was on the other floor. Here's volume 1 again. All right, let's go down. Let's go down. And, that was not good. Well, I'll eat a fruit. Okay, apparently I'll leave... Oh, I see these little balls have fruits on them. Give me a fruit. Okay, I'm all healed up. So I was right. It's just repeating, I guess. So there's 3 we've read. Where's 2? This must be 2. Thousands of years passed, and the old ones slumbered in their prison. In the late 19th century, archaeologists in Arabia unearthed a site where the binding ritual had been invoked. The disturbance rippled throughout the fabric of the cosmos and awoke the ancient beings. Forgotten horror spilled forth, and Earth was again in peril. So, I don't know if you've ever read any H.P. Lovecraft. I've only read a few of the stories that were more of a short variety. They ain't no joke. The old ones were like the creators of reality, I guess. And Cthulhu is one of them, as far as I recall. In the early 20th century, when the old ones threatened Earth for the second time, the Guardians reconvened in New England, performed the ritual of binding once again. A modest library was chosen to host the rite, and the Guardians elected one among them, the Librarian, to remain at the prison and protect it from further disturbances. At a small library in New England, presumably where we are now, the Guardians performed the arcane ritual of binding to imprison the old ones. The Librarian, a singular guardian chosen to protect the site, was blocked away with the terrible beings. Yep, I'm the Librarian. But unbeknownst to the other guardians, the errant words spoken during the ritual shattered the Librarian's mind and memories. So apparently I'm nuts, which was also one of the recurring themes in the H.P. Lovecraft stuff. Like, you would go mad because your mind was not intended to witness certain things that it would in his stories. One of which I think was Cthulhu, some like other stuff. There's other beasties and things that would drive a man crazy. They always came in the form of prophetic visionary dreams or things like that in his stories, anyway, that I recall. And again, I'm no Lovecraft expert by any means. I think I've read maybe 2 or 3 short stories. So this is pretty labyrinthian. Labyrinthian? Labyrinthine? Not sure how to pronounce that. But I can see now how it can get pretty crazy quickly. And I'm going to guess this is just we've reached a repeating kind of pattern here with these things. These books, rather. I'm kind of disappointed there's not secrets and stuff that exist. I don't remember if there were or not when I watched the Let's Play before, but I do remember that it was pretty easy to get lost. So let's see what we can see, I guess. I know there's something that we're supposed to be doing with those sparkly ones, so I don't want to go too far off on a tangent, but I do want to just explore a little bit up here and see if there's anything worth venturing forward for, or just getting the lay of the land. I have a feeling at one point, just based on the design of this library, the level will be populated with beasties and monsters of some kind. It's just my hunch. Yeah, it's just repeating here. Or, right, so the game designer was obviously wanting people to read the books to find out the history and stuff. Whoa! I was flying there, actually. So it looks like if you get a running start in books, you can walk through. Okay, so it looks like I can jump about 1, 2, 3, 4 blocks, maybe? Let's try that again. And around there. Probably I might be able to make this jump. Let's try it. And I'm going to put away my alcohol. Oops. I thought I could with X. Here I go. Jump. Okay, so I can go from that far anyway. So it looks like we're at the top level of this thing now. Doesn't look like there's anything more to do. So I guess I will try not to fall down and hurt myself. I'm always having problems with ladders in these kinds of games too. Like I go to find it and then apparently crouch is the ticket here. So you go up the ladder, just walking towards it, and then as you look up, it ascends. And then as you press C and backwards, it will descend. All right, so I'm just gonna try and find that sparkly area. I think I need to go down a couple more levels. I'm just gonna run around this real quick and see if there's anything to note or do around. There's some fruits on this tree. It's good to know for later in case I need it. No shift, so you won't fall off the ledge like in Minecraft. So I need to find the staircase in which to traverse downward. And I'm gonna guess it's here, yep. Called it. Okay, C, backwards, latch on, good. Pretty cool lighting effects, I will say. I kinda like the vignette too when you're crouched to hint at, oh, there's a map right in front of my face in the corner. Wow, that's interesting. What happens if I go up? Okay, it like recalcs. And then I presume that this means, what does that mean, that little triangle? Okay, there's a up or down there, I guess. Orange means I'm on the current one. I don't know. Well, I guess that means there's something above that's an option. Okay, got it. 10-4, pretty easy to understand. But as I was saying, I like the vignette around when you're like hiding, you're tucked away. Like, don't kid me, don't get me, bad guys. I promise I won't be a jerk. Okay, let's go to these sparkly thingies and see. Now, I don't recall them being three different colors, but I think I came from a different way. Obviously, I'm meant to do something here, and I don't want to do it just yet. I want to keep looking around a minute. Okay, so, right, let's take a look in the chest. There's got to be some goodies in here. You can deposit your artifacts in bank chests for safekeeping. Artifacts you deposit here can be withdrawn later at this or any other chest. Okay, cool. When you die, your possessions will be lost, but the artifacts in the chest will remain. 10-4. So, I guess this is saying put your money in. That's fine. Is that what I did? I can't tell. Player has two. Oh, I see. This is me on top, and this is the bank on the bottom. So now I have zero monies, and if I go here, I can get more monies back. Got it. Okay, so that's how we deposit and withdraw. 10-4. Okay. This is a strange book. This is a strange book. This is also a strange book. All right, so I'm going to go for the strange books before I go for the others, and just maybe because I'm a linear thinker, I'm going to go for the one that's open first. This book is not written in a language you do not. This book is written in a language you do not recognize. As you peer at the strange glyphs, they seem to lift off the pages and take on the bizarre and unearthly forms of the world and creatures they describe. Cool. The words encircle you, blotting out the library and filling your mind with the unbearable buzzing of a pre-human language. Shaken, you try to close the book, but find yourself transported to the alien world described in its pages. Guessing that takes me to a new level. Called it. Okay. That's creepy. Now, can I save? I can, but I have to quit at the same time. I'm in Dagon 1. I have no gear. I can resurrect. I have no souls. Okay. That must be how I get back to the library, so that's good to know. I'm gonna scooch around like a gear's wearable equipment that improves your abilities. Gear comes in three categories: boots, kits, and gadgets. You carry one piece of gear. Gotcha. Simple magnetic compass. Carrying a compass reveals key locations on your mini map. Compass also points to the exit of the current level. Okay. okay, so that green thing must have just shown up because I don't remember it being there. And the compass, I guess I just pick up. Can I move it? I can't, okay. Maybe it just swaps it with the other. Something quite peculiar has happened to me. I feel the need to record this in the event that I should not return. The last thing I recall, I was examining that curious book in the library, and now I have found myself in a dangerous world full of lurking monsters and treacherous traps. If my research is correct, then I am in a lost temple to the ancient god Dagon. A powerful relic is rumored to be kept in the depths of this world. Perhaps it holds the key to my escape. Perhaps, indeed. Let's see, I'm a little nervous because I got a bottle of booze and I'm in a different plane of existence. I can hear nasty things happening around me. Right. Okay, there's a fish dude. Hey, fishy fish fish. Should I whip the bottle at him? Gluck, 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 indeed. So there's not a friendly area. I'm not going in there, obviously. Not meant to, I guess. I guess I could probably jump it and try and grab the ham sandwich. Not feeling that right now. But I am feeling this. I'm going over this way. Shit. Hi. Please don't kill me. Okay, I'm going away from you. I'm presuming you like to eat meaty tenderloins like me. With my stylish attire. Okay. It's over here. Okay, there's like some kind of statue. Looks like there's no other way to get in this room, maybe. Oh, spoke too soon. There's an above and a side. But it doesn't look like anyone is in here. I'm hesitant to just walk around, but I think that's kind of what they want. What do I do with this? Do I... Hypnotic statue. I can pray to it. That's creepy. Alright. These enormous stone idols depict some sort of terrible creature never seen on Earth. Praying at the statue imbues you with a special power from the old ones. Yay, me. Aim at a creature and press the right mouse button to hypnotize it. Hypnotized creatures will fight for you. Be careful. Strong-willed creatures may shake off the hypnotic effect after a short time. It costs 7 blue discs to use hypnotize. Okay, so now I can hypnotize people. Alright. Trying to get a bead on me. I wonder if the light factors in my visibility, if this game is like Thief, where the amount of light that hits you determines your visibility to the AI monsters or not. I'm not sure. I definitely want to get a weapon. I hope that there's pistols and things like that, like in Alone in the Dark, or swords or something, because I got a bottle. I'm pretty sure this is not meant as a weapon, but meant as a way to get the attention of things away from you. Apparently this is made out of like a mushroom. It's supposed to be wood though. Looks like mycelium from Minecraft. Alright, I'm standing up. I'm done creeping around here. The layout of these stones is weird. Uh-oh. Shit. I just heard some wet clopping and some heavy breathing. And because I'm new to this, I'm not sure how far away those guys might be. That sounded pretty close. Like on the left side of me. I think what I'm gonna have to do is find one of these guys, stand near him, and see exactly how far away I need to be before he detects me so that I can get more peace of mind about how I play the remainder of the game. Yeah, let's do that. There's a lot of stuff to explore up here. I could hop up there. Now that's where I came from, right? That's back to the library, or no? Yeah, because that's the journal. Okay. Or no, that's not the library. Or that's where I gotta go. That little green thing. Uh-oh, that's a wizard. I think he sees me. Yep, he sees me. Alright. Alright, dude. I'm gonna try and take this fool out, too. My punches. Take that, motherfucker. Looting. Search corpses for ammo, artifacts, or other items. After being looted, the enemy may respawn somewhere in the level. Okay, I got a gold thing. What that means, I have no idea. But apparently the bottle actually made a difference. So I feel a little bit more empowered with this bottle, as a result. It looks like I can go up, down, sideways. So, yeah, okay. I get the feeling that, is this where I did come from? Yeah, and that is back to the library, right? Yeah. I get the feeling that, I'm gonna get lost here in that little tiny 4x4 map. Probably isn't enough. To keep me from not getting lost. I'm not good at temporal directions, just in life, let alone in computer games. All right, there's a ladder over there. It would be nice if I could maybe zoom that thing in and out the map, but let's go up here. Oh, nice, I'm glad I came up. I don't need to eat, but I will pick up, definitely. Okay, I guess I can only have 2 bottles. Yeah, dagger. Take that any day over a bottle. Okay, these are called artifacts. The blue discs are artifacts, okay. So I have enough to, I needed 7 to cast that spell or whatever with right click. And now I have 8, so I can at least do that if I get scared and find somebody that's like this fish dude. Maybe we can sneak up on this guy. Over here, buddy. Here, fishy, fish, fish, fish. Here, fishy, fish, 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 fish. You don't want none of this? You sure, bud? You sure about that? Oh, I think you do. Yeah, take that, buddy. Got 2. Grandfather clocks off you. I don't know if there's like a backstab functionality. Is that dynamite? It is. So I can only have 1 weapon at a time. I want the dagger and dynamite. Oh, I see. I can only carry 2 things at once and X switches. Got it. So dynamite, I imagine, blows stuff up. I missed. Or no, I did get him. See ya. All your relics are belong to me. Artifacts, I mean. Okay. Doing pretty good. Got 4 artifacts left. Let's go over here. I feel a little bit more empowered. Is it a rock? I don't know if I should jump down here, though. Hey. Hey, buddy. You made me do it. I was gonna leave you alone, but... Yes, I'm not sure if I want to jump down here. I'm gonna go this way first. Gluck, 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 gluck. Gluck, Okay. Avoid the spikes, which is a strange place to put spikes. Unless maybe you fall through the ceiling up there or something. I don't know. It's interesting. I'm not sure about the rhyme or reason for the selection of textures here either. Like if it's... Ooh, there's a door. Ooh, there's a ham sandwich. Nom, 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 nom. Although I don't need it yet. I'll leave it for later. And if I run over it, I don't pick it up. So that's cool. Let's go in this door. Not about to kill the clucker. Come here, buddy. What? What? Huh? Give me your grandfather clack. All right. Can I look in here? No. Okay. Let's go in. Oh boy. All right. Yes. Okay. Not there yet. Ooh, that's a little creepy crawler. Here, buddy. Come here, buddy. Want some? Give me your grandfather clock. Another door. Is this where the same room? I wonder. It's locked. I need a key. All right. New mission. Find key. Okay. This is, yeah, the levels are very samey. It's going to be difficult not to get lost. That's pretty steep right there, too. Yikes. Okay. Okay. Ah, I see. Did I just trigger something? What's this? Can't do anything with it. There's a key. Ooh, and a gun. All right, I'm going for it. Let's jump it. Ah, I did it. Okay, now I'll keep the dynamite. And the key I definitely want. Yes, yep. Only wants and baked meat. Don't need that yet. I might after this jump though. Nope, I don't need it. Apparently my blade can still be picked up from the outside. So that's cool. Let's come over here as far as we can and see if we can keep the blade. Hopefully it stays there. So that's where I came from. Now I got a gun, yo. And I ain't afraid to use it, son. Ain't afraid. I got a gun now. Okay, I can obviously go down there, but not in the healthy, safe way. Let's go this way. Look, look, look. Okay. Cool. Here's some ticking sound. Ooh, I don't want rotten meat. I definitely want the key. Don't need the dagger. I guess the benefit of the dagger might be to... not use ammo, maybe? I don't know if the gun has perpetual amounts of ammo or not. I'm gonna leave the door open so I know that I've already been there. Okay. Rope? 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 Glug, 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 glug. That's where I came from. This is just the same way to go out there, through that little hole. All right. I hear him, but I don't know where he's coming from. Probably over there somewhere. Or he's maybe behind the wall. I don't know. I just heard a door, I think. I don't know. It's not clear to me. There he is. Sorry, bud. Need those artifacts. Okay. Look, look, look. Okay, I think I go out here. This is where I came from. Yep, because there's the ham I didn't eat. What? What are you guys just doing hanging out in here? That's the real question that I should be asking. Just stairs? Yeah, let's go down. Actually, not yet. Not yet. I want to go over here. Moment. There are stairs here as well. It's just a matter of where I want to go down, I suppose. And there's kind of a weird portal area. Definitely. Okay, so that's where I would have fallen. No, it's not. It's not the same. I think there was an area where there was a rock or something. Isn't it over here? Okay, that's definitely the book and stuff. The journal, right? Okay, it was over there, I think. Yeah, because that's where I came from. I think it was over here. No? Where the heck was I? That's the cave area. Nah, yourself. Oh, punk. Need to eat some ham finally. Was it here? Yeah, it was here. Okay, so let's fall here. Pick up a rock. I don't know, man. I think gun beats rock. For sure. If it were me doing the judging. What's up there? Some goodies. I want them. Another gun and another key. I think I have 3 keys at this time. 3 keys. Are those bullets? The 13? And not grandfather clocks? Like I thought. Maybe they are bullets. I don't know. But why would people who didn't have weapons drop bullets? And more importantly, how do I get over there? Okay. Is there like a... Oh, hi. Hi, dude. Come on over here for a minute. I want to tell you something. Thanks for your artifacts. That's what I wanted to tell you. Give me all your artifacts. What's going on in here? You guys hanging out and having a party? I want a party. So let's eat the ham sandwich. So based on the current ways that I've seen things, and actually let's leave that open. Oh, there's a ladder. That's how you get up. Hello? With a ladder. Whoop. Whoop. Where you at, fool? Huh? Huh? Where you at? Huh? Where you at? And some guns. Apparently I gotta get off the ladder to pick things up. Those must be bullets. I think they're bullets, not grandfather clocks. Huh? 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 What? So far there's quite a bit of health. That's nice touch that he dies instantly if I hit him without him knowing. But it seems like there's quite a lot of health, so it doesn't look like I need to be super paranoid. I'm just gonna kinda go for it now. Got my bearings on, know where I'm going, kinda have a better idea. Ooh, that's a snake. Yikes. Apparently you can go down ladders by just crouching. Should I go down here? Take this guy out from above.
Death from above.
Give me your blue artifacts. So, is this literally just like trying to find the green door? Because that's kind of weak sauce. Can I have more than one dynamite? No. Well, I guess I could if I wanted to sacrifice my other weapon slot. And I don't really want to. I want to go up here though. Look. More bullets. Millions of bullets. Bullets for me. Now, can I get up there through some kind of ladder or something. There's some stuff up there. Wait, I was over there already. Dirt. Let's go over here. Huh? What? Huh? Huh? Do snakes make haw sounds? That's pretty goofy if so. Come here, snake. Hey, buddy. What do you got? What are you doing? Can you see what happens when you attack me? You little snake. Ah! Okay, I didn't expect his whole head to open. That was a little scary. And I'm done down here, I think. Hey. What? What? Huh? Look. Alright. What? Alright, I've been here. And I'm pretty sure I've been here. Oops. I'm just gonna go up anyway. Get up there, fool. Okay, I'm definitely climbing that ladder. Alright. So, right, I don't need to go up there. I've been over around here. Have I been through here? This does not look familiar. Maybe this is the way I came. Ooh. Come here, do you get impaled by your own spikes? That's not very fair. You're spike immune. Well, that sucks then. That's no good. I guess I'll just jump through. Do I have enough room? Yeah. Ah, I knew that was gonna happen. Oh, it took two. Damn, I need to find me some ham hock. I need a ham sandwich stat. Alright, where can I find something to eat? I think over this way. Yep. If I don't die here, this could be pretty short. Yep. I'm hosed. Death. When your health is depleted, you will die. After death, you will be resurrected in the library. Your possessions will be lost, but the artifacts in your bank chest will stay. So I have, like, two artifacts in there. Whee! And any books you have unlocked will remain unlocked. You can also start a new life at any time by selecting resurrect in the pause menu. Yay. What? Tweet that I died? Give me a break. I'm gonna do that next time. Alright, so. That's what that does. So apparently I can't do anything. This book is bound, blah, blah, blah. It has been sealed, right. So these I can't go to yet. I don't even care what they say. This is open. What's in here? Is this something that's the history again? Yep. So let's try this blue one. This is looking interesting. Was this book here before? Yep. The pages of the book flap wildly as an icy wind swirls around you. The mountains of madness await. Okay, it's a different level. Okay, there's a plane. Okay. What's that? Soapstone. A greenish star-shaped fragment of soapstone. It has no effect. Okay. That's supposed to be a trapdoor? Yeah. Okay, so this is the end of the level there, I guess. Just a big cube. The plane obviously can't be flown, I don't think. Not much to do here, from what I can tell. Maybe this is something that becomes more prominent as you go. I'm pretty sure I can't make that jump. Yeah, I can't. I can make this one. Oh, no, I can't. Well, at least I didn't die. Let's go down now, I guess, since we were up. Yeah, I'm guessing that something happens with this later, and then I don't have dynamite or anything right now. I wonder if, keys to the airplane are missing. You can't take off without them. Oh, I see. So maybe this is, like, the way to go home and close the story out. Oh, I didn't expect that. Can I take a torch? Nope. What do you think this is? Legend of Grimlock. I like these low-res games for some reason, I don't know. I'm a sucker for them. I feel like... Ooh! What happened? That icicle fell on my head? Well, that's bullshit. Ow! Well, fine. I won't walk under those anymore. How's that? In fact, well, maybe. Give me that. And that. I'm gonna blow shit up. If I can find something to blow up. It's worthy of blowing up. Okay. So, is there a way to, like, troll these? Like, run through them or something? It seems to have worked. Is that a giant penguin? Alright. That's creepy. Hi, penguin. Are you a nice penguin? Ah! Apparently not. You dick. Alright, so... one more run through. And then I'm gonna call it quits. And I have a new strategy. So I'm not going... yeah, I will. Alright, let's find the trapdoor. I think it's in front of the plane. Alright. Alright, I'm just gonna be adventurous here and see if I can find my dynamite again. A few icicles. I find it odd that an icicle would just happen to fall if I was standing near it, like, and it's only when I'm directly under it, you know, like, it's not, whatever, it seems cheap to me, like, if I run, am I gonna hit it in the head? Let's try that. Running, no, not enough time to get out of the way for the running to save me from the icicle, so I can take one more hit and then hit it. Yep. Alright. So yeah, that was Eldritch. And I will definitely keep playing this. But first impressions are, it looks fun. A lot of different things to do. Apparently, I'm not very good at this yet. Part of it is that I'm timid. Or was timid. I can't reach that unless I could push something like Soko Band style up there. Or maybe you're not meant to reach it in that way. Maybe you're meant to go up there through another way and climb down that way only. Anyway, that's it. Oh, that's where the plant was, I think. So yeah, to be continued at a later point. Hopefully it was interesting. See ya.